Hi, I'm Zach Lopes, senior second baseman for the University of Delaware, with another edition of Now and Then with Darren Pulito. I just want to thank you for your time and thanks for coming out. Take me back to when you played. Notice any changes in the way the game's played, the personnel, the technology? Like, what are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think the most obvious difference, at least as it pertains to Delaware, is the new stadium. When we played, you know, we worked hard at keeping the, and we had a beautiful stadium, but we worked hard at it. A lot of shoveling, a lot of tarps, and Coach Sherm was just, that was his baby, and it still is his baby, but we worked very hard at keeping that stadium ship shape. Now, with the turf, with the heated dugouts,
yes.
There's definitely a little bit of jealousy. I can remember one weekend we had a doubleheader with, actually we had one game on Saturday and one game on Sunday with UConn. And Saturday's game was actually iced out. It wasn't snowed out, it was iced out. And we had to break the ice on Saturday to play a doubleheader on Sunday in a minus 20 wind chill. I'll never ever forget that series. So I'm happy for you guys that you get to sit in the warm dugout and not worry about a tarp.
Thank you.
But
that's from all the hard work you guys put in the past, though.
Well, it was Sherm was a good general on the field.
What was like your favorite, I don't know, favorite memory, I guess, of being part of the University of Delaware baseball team? Like the teammates, the relationships you had, anything like that?
I don't know if there's one in particular. There are a few that definitely stand out. Being fortunate enough to be on teams that had a lot of wins, I think. I think the least amount of losses we had wins was 43.
Wow.
And I think we had 44 and 45 in the 3 years that I was here. So we enjoyed a lot. Leading to that, one of my favorite standout memories is gathering as a team in front of the televisions for the selection show and finding out where you're going.
Yeah.
And the first year, I remember we were upstairs here. And we were over at the Bob, and we're all huddled around the television, and the local media was there, and we didn't get picked. And then finally, the last bracket, or the last regional that was available was Wichita. So we knew we were going to Wichita State to play.
All the way to Kansas.
And that's just elite. I mean, they've always been a perennial powerhouse. Mm-hmm. When they finally call our name, we drew Cal State Fullerton, which were the defending national champions.
Darren, you had a highly decorated career, being an All-American in 1997. Eventually, baseball came to an end. How would you describe the process of transitioning from a collegiate athlete to going into the work world?
My playing career came to an end faster than I wanted it to. I guess that happens with everybody at some point. But sports and baseball in particular, really can prepare you for the workforce out of school. You know, whether it's the teamwork aspect and the chemistry of the teamwork, leadership, time management, even things as little
exactly.
as that can really set you on a better path and a few steps ahead of the next guy. And looking at people that I want to work with, people I want to invest in, people I may hire. A lot of times I will take an extra hard look at former athletes, former servicemen, because you know that they have a work ethic, you know, whether it's innate or somebody drilled them into it during their experience, that will definitely prepare them for life after, you know, after college or after sports.
What advice would you give to a incoming freshman who's new to this whole college process, or a senior like myself who's kind of coming up to the end of things here in terms of being a student athlete? What kind of advice would you give to either one of them, knowing that, hey, this is the start of something and it's the end of something?
Well, to the incoming freshman, I would say enjoy every minute of it. Don't take one day for granted, because it's going to be over like that, as you know. To someone that's a senior and getting ready to finish out their last year, I would say hang on to the dream of baseball and playing at the next level. Do anything you can to try to achieve that goal. whether it's leaning on coaches, leaning on any other coaches that you may have played with in the summertime. Get yourself out there, get yourself known. And that kind of correlates into going into the workforce. I think one of the great things about Delaware and the alumni here is that we're engaged, and we're becoming more engaged recently. The stadium project, I think, brought a lot of us together, but we're always happy to reach out or to hear from current athletes and do anything we can to help them. Meet as many people as you can. Try to find maybe some alumni that are in a field that you're interested in. And I can't imagine anyone not willing to help out a current athlete.
Right.
Now that the project's over, how could can you tell a difference in the how the alumni react to it? And now that it's done, what would you say?
Well, I think the stadium project was a great facilitator and a great reason to get everybody re-engaged with the program. You know, Eric's involvement and Coach Sherm and Coach Hammer, their involvement and excitement and enthusiasm around getting the stadium done, and you know, in the name of Coach Hanna, I think it really re-engaged a lot of us. And my hope is that your era sees what can be done by getting people involved more and what can be accomplished. I think it's very important that that you take a leadership role, and once you transition out of Delaware, to stay involved and stay engaged, because it's a big sense of pride for me, looking back, 14 years or so, being removed, to be able to see a project like that come together. It's a great sense of accomplishment, and it's a team effort.
Well, we thank you so much for that, and all the hard work you've put in throughout the years, and your fellow alumni, and now we get to benefit after all the hard work you guys put in, and the hard-earned dollars and everything. So we all thank you for that.
Well, you can thank us and by getting to postseason, making us proud.
We're going to do our best. Darren, thank you so much for sitting down with us and reminiscing. It's a great time having you here, and just looking forward to the season and looking forward to you to come back again, and maybe we'll talk more and catch up later.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me. It was an honor. Appreciate it.
I'm Zach Lopes. Thank you for watching this edition of Now and Then.